Hello everyone, my name is Droogie Forever, and today we're playing The Shattering. This game just came out today, April 21st, 2020, and it is $20, $19.99. It's on sale for launch week at $17.99, and I bought it today, and I thought we'd play it. The patient seems to be stable and ready for the next session. I will try to reason with him about the latest events, though we struggle. I proceed with optimism. Dr. W. Richards.
A different dose this time. I know you're tired, John, but we need to take you deeper. We must try again. I know you think everything is all right. Then tell me.
Every little thing.
Why can't you even remember her name?
Gonna be all right.
All right. Let's try one more time. Are you ready?
One more time.
I would like you to look directly into the pendulum and follow it with your eyes. Yes, just like that.
I'm following when I count down pendulum.
From 3 to 0, imagine yourself here in this room. Try to relax. Let your memories guide you.
I'm naked in this room.
Yes. Good.
He likes it.
Now, let's begin. 3, 2, 1, 0.
Can you hear me, John? I'm right here.
It's very white.
I see you're having trouble settling in. Let's take it slowly. I want you to think of something that will help you see clearly. You have the power to influence everything here. So I want you to help yourself.
Help me. Help you.
Interesting choice, John.
Don't take the pills.
Oh, interesting choice. Now, I want you to imagine yourself standing up from that chair.
Very white in here. Spike Lee wouldn't like this.
Good. But there's something missing. Let's make sure you're oriented. Find the source of my voice and focus on it.
Did you see that, John? You imagined yourself in a room with no detail, but with a little effort, you were able to remember. The truth is buried inside of you. There's more to your life than this chair or this room. You must remember. Playing games is just a distraction, John. You're doing well, John. I don't think you need those now.
I want to take them.
John, let's continue. I want you to take a step back.
Oops.
Do you remember what brought you here? Are you satisfied?
Let's see.
John, you were at the hospital. Do you remember why?
Looks like a car accident. One more time.
Not everything is as it seems.
January
13th, 2005. Don't be afraid to look closer. Try to remember. John, look at the new time here is only an illusion. A moment can seem a lifetime, and a lifetime can seem just a moment. Playing games is just a distraction, John.
I know, but it's fun. You seem to be bent out of shape about it. Car accident.
Do you remember now?
That is super white.
Can you see the accident? John. John. The accident. Always the accident. John, can you hear me? Take a deep breath. You are overwhelmed. We need to try something different. Your mind is conflicting with your memories. Let's try smaller steps. I want you to think about where you were before the accident. What did you do that day? What did you see? What did you hear?
I'm pretty sure I was in bed all day.
Each link will help you remember.
Diddle, diddle, diddle in the corner of my room. And I feel now.
Keep going, John. Good, John.
Okay, so we were at a hotel diddling. Diddling, diddling, diddling.
A
room
key card,
611.
John. Which door does it open?
611.
Find a link to take you back, John.
My typewriter.
That's it, John. Remembering will open new doors. I want you to submit to the memory. Don't be afraid to go deeper without me. Go and tell me your story, John.
611. All right. So we know we have to go in there. I'm just curious what's up here. What are you? Whoa. It won't let me open it. Navigating recent memories is proving difficult. The patient has found anchors from before the accident. The memories recalled have led him to the gates of the hotel. Dr. W. Richards. This game's pretty good so far. Perfect place to get inspired for writing. Yes, I think I shall. I think I shall, Codsworth. Ding ding! I'll be right back. Okay there, Arnold. That's alright, it'll give me time to think of some ideas for the book. That's interesting. Alright, let's go up here and see what we got. Ding ding. Something about science. I know, it blinded me. Blinded me with science. Perhaps history. Don't know much about history. Don't know much biology. History of Pomerina. Dump out the ashes. This isn't the time for historical research. What? Okay. So I can sit back down, but I don't think I could pick anything else up. So, yeah. Don't know much about history. Don't know much about biology. What a wonderful something, something, something. I don't know the words to that song. Maybe romance. Be mine. Would you be mine? Take this ring. Without change, there would be no butterflies. There's an invisible woman here, and an invisible baby. Okay, hey, you coming? You coming down? Perhaps a children's story. Perhaps a story involving a tiara. And a magic wand. And a wooden boat. Fairy tales are not for me. Alright, I'll look at the... Much better. What can I say? No! After I've taken the blame. We broke the glass. Actually, this gives me an idea. Drama. Drama, drama, drama. Drama! Drama, 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 drama. Sorry, I'm super tired, guys. I've been recording half the day and there's like not a lot of usable footage here, so forgive me. Yes, this will be perfect. But what was that? Should I go see what that is? I guess so. Let's go see what we got over here. No one will see it coming. I mean, I'll see it coming. What's that? Oh, there was a ball there. Is it this? That looked weird. I guess it was. For some reason, I thought there was a ball there, and it's the ball in that. So I'm an idiot.
Mr. Evans, we are glad to inform you that your room is ready. Please sign into the guest book.
Okay, I do that.
Thank you. We wish you a pleasant stay.
Okay. Room 611. Got my card. Alright, so how do I get there? Oh, the elevator's open now. Alright. Time for me to take some sexy pictures in this hotel and put them on my OnlyFans. Hey, my bag disappeared! Sons of bees took my bag. I can't go that way. Well, I assumed that... that's the exit. Those are locked. Okay. So what do I do? I grab my bag? Okay. Keep expecting the mirrors to break since they did last time. Wait, did the numbers just start over? They did.
Mr. Evans, there's a woman calling for you. She seems very concerned.
Is the sweetheart you married the husband you expected him to be? Has the war created new problems for you in your marriage?
There's blood on that. The door's locked. Really? We both know I just got here. It can't be locked. Come on now. It's a bathroom. No hotel bathroom is friggin' locked. Okay. Seeing it, what I can interact with. Peace and quiet, cigarette to calm down, and my typewriter is all I need. Wait, where's my bag though? It's gone. What's it? Need a quick smoke before starting. Alright. Typewriter, all I need is a cigarette. Pick up those coins. Enter a 4-digit number and press the number key. Oh. Okay. I just thought we could just enter whatever. I thought... Oh, wait, hold on. Hold on. How do I have a smoke? I guess I need my cigarettes. I don't know how to open that thing, though. Wait. Nah, even focusing, I can't really see what's there. January 10th. Okay, daughter is left, wardrobe, suitcase down, took out the typewriter, sound of water, found only the Bible, lighter, ready to start writing the story, but there's no... code on there, so I don't know what the code is. Oh, nice. Okay. There we go. Okay, got the cigarettes. Cool, cool. Perfect, now I can write a story. It was a stormy night, and the rain wasn't showing any signs of stopping. There was tension in the air, and no, that doesn't sound right. Remember, drama! She gripped the edge of the balcony with all her strength, not wanting to let go. She screamed for help, and she left. Can't you remember your brilliant idea? How about a glass of wine to loosen the memory? Cork. Wine. It's really just grape juice. Drink. Perfect. Write a story. Let's try again. All she needed to do was focus on the future. She knew there would be no more noise, no more interruptions. Someone there? Who's there? No more interruptions. She could hear her heart beating in her ears. Her pulse was racing. Everything came down to this moment, this one breath that would change everything. Not again! Ugh. Can't they leave me alone? Room service. Next time they open that door, I'm gonna stab them in the neck. Nothing made sense anymore. She couldn't think straight. She couldn't focus. She couldn't find the rhythm of her own heart. Every attempt at any action ended in suffering. Unbelievable.
Thank you for choosing the Azure Hotel. We hope you're enjoying our services. Is there anything we can get you to help you enjoy your stay?
You can leave me alone.
Of course, Mr. Evans. I know exactly what you need.
Stab her with it. What the hell is this? It went right through me. Actually, this could help. But once things started to make sense, everything she saw was with her own eyes. As soon as her perspective changed, she saw the world for what it really was. Opportunity was behind every window and door. The night was dark. Calmness settled in. She could feel her body. She could feel her what? I can't remember! How about some help? How could I forget? Yes, some wine. Some wine. Just a little. Just a little bit more wine. What is that? Stop that noise! 7. The noise. Seven's the only digit I have found. One more, then we can work. I turned that off.
Created new problems for you in your marriage.
Silence.
To answer these and other personal problems brought in by your friends and neighbors, Arid presents John J. Anthony, founder of the famed Marital Relations Institute.
3. 7-3. Peace. We need peace. Make it stop. 7-3-0. Nine, 7-3-0-9 or 7-3-0-6. Hey! It opened! Codebreaker! I've got a gun! That's all I need is a gun? I will never leave you. Ten 13, that's the same time on the clock out there. That's the same time on the clock in the hotel room. Peace and quiet. End of Act 1. The patient's mind has begun to respond to the treatment. The desire to focus on the book provides opportunities to slip through the cracks. Still, we've reached the precipice of the truth and can go no further. We must try a different approach.
John, come back to me. Breathe and relax, John. Listen to the ticking of the clock. You're safe here. Writing the book. Isolation. Despair.
Despair!
It's hard to see the separation between the past and the mind.
All right, guys, I'm going to go ahead and stop this here since it just saved it. I need to go to bed. It's pretty late. So I will see you in part 2. This is pretty damn good, I think. So I'm enjoying it. I hope you guys are, too. If you are, tell that like button. You want to smash. And don't forget to subscribe. You stay you. I'll stay me. Driggy forever. Thank you, everybody, so much for watching. I really appreciate it. And I will see you in the next video. Later.